Season's greetings, as they say, even though there are four seasons, so it's always season's greetings. Here's the update. The first thing on the update are the winners of the competition. Congratulations to Kyle and Vincent, chosen at random with a supercomputer and the force of the wind, who each got special editions added to their order and put in the boxes. Speaking of orders, everything's been packaged, which is to say that pick and pack is completely done. We're currently waiting on the last step of the process, where we get a confirmation for our order of shipping space. Once that's done, the mass of orders hits the ocean and we can try to calculate the estimated deliveries in each country. So that's cool. But while we wait, why not put a couple extra special editions in some people's packages? To enter the contest, just like last time, put one of these things in the comments and we'll take care of it. I think we're gonna have two more winners in this video and then two more in the next one, which is the last one. On to the topic. Just like the last one, I recorded the intro at a different time. So I'm here now in the same gray shirt because I haven't moved yet and the sun went down. In the players section of the book, there are 16 new spells. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about my favorite five. Starting with Gather Animals. We all know the classic summoning of pulling a spirit from a different dimension and having it become an animal, but it's not actually an animal, it's like a fae or an undead. But what about the real animals? What about far too many of them? Well, this second level enchantment spell has the answer that you seek. Available to bards, druids, and rangers, Gather Animals lets you call the name of one beast of challenge rating 1/2 or less. And after the minute that it takes to cast, or the 11 minutes if you cast it as a ritual, every available beast within a 1/2 mile radius convenes on your location. With no direction, they just show up. That's the best part of the spell, they just show up and they hang out for a minute. So it's up to you what happens after that. Like imagine just standing in a market square and calling all the local cats or chickens to your aid, and then 300 chickens show up and you're just like,
look at all those chickens!
Screeching scents. You ever know of a bat? Just like a bat? You know how they scream, and when they scream they can see bugs really easy and then they eat the bugs because they screamed? Well, this first level divination spell lets you rip off a bat and scream really loud to see really good. Available to a bunch of spellcasters, when you use a bonus action you go, eh. And then you get a black and white image of the area within 120 feet of yourself. The detail of this image is determined by your spellcasting modifier instead of your perception, which is very nice. Tone of the Shepherd. This is me ripping off the Shepherd's Tone, but making it magic. Shepherd's Tone is an auditory illusion that constantly sounds like it's getting louder because our brains are stupid. So when a bard, a druid, or a ranger pops a third level spell slot, they can create this tune for up to a minute. Everyone nearby takes a bunch of psychic damage for every turn that they can't figure out what's happening. So that's cool. I would have made it brown note, but I think command already does that when you tell someone to go poo poo. Circle of Summoning. This is one of the higher level spells, clocking in at a whopping 5 slot machines. It's also only available to druids and wizards. For an hour, you draw a big circle in the ground and you pick one type of outsider. And for the next 12 hours after that, whenever you cast a summoning spell inside that circle, the summoned thing lasts for a heck of a lot longer. It's one of those spells where if you cast it every day for a year in the same location, it sticks around forever. You know, the kind of spells that only villains and non-player characters use? If I had one, I'd probably designate Fae, and then conjure 8 giant constrictor snakes and just have them hang out at my house all the time. Just wiggling around, constricting stuff like my fridge and my toilet and my lamps. Okay. Evolve Beast. Grab a dragon's feather, the feet of a quipper, and fancy gemstones that you're okay with losing forever. Then grab whatever beast you prefer, like a cat or a pug or a capybara. Then spend about 8 hours unraveling its genetic code and you poop out the ultimate evolution. A cat that has crazy sharp claws and armor plating and gills and lungs and it can fly now, and it has a bunch of health. This particular spell has a beautiful illustration to go with it, which is one of the many amazing pieces in the book, and all our artists did fantastic work through and through. I'm real happy with it. Oh yeah, those were some of the spells. I hope you like them, or maybe you hated them. In which case you wouldn't still be watching, so I can reactively call you a stinky poo-poo man. Bad viewer. Okay, to everyone else, let me know what you thought. If you liked the video, if you liked the spells, or what you think of the book as a whole. It's in the description. Goodbye.